What's up, beautiful people? Welcome back to my channel. I'm Erin, and this is Erin On Demand, a place for entrepreneurs and content creators looking to build your brand, business, and impact. And today, we are talking all about resources for entrepreneurs. You guys, while we are going through this uncertain time, there are so many resources, and it's constantly changing. I mean, by the day, there are new updates and things changing. And my mom and I have been keeping a pretty good pulse on what's going on as it pertains to the PPP, the EIDL, different stimulus check updates. And so because my audience is full of entrepreneurs, I feel very compelled to share with you guys a lot of the things that are going on as I find them out, just to kind of make them easier for you to understand and to make sure that you are also taking advantage of these resources that are really at our disposal. So I will preface this with saying these little pop-ins may happen pretty frequently because things are changing so much, but I also want to let you know that I won't be editing these. So if I do look down, it's because I have some notes on my phone that I want to make sure I hit and get these updates to you as quickly as possible. So the first thing is that on June 30th, the PPP deadline was extended to August 8th. So if you did not take advantage of the PPP, you still have time. You have until August 8th. Now, basically what this means is that if you have a business with less than 500 employees, your business may be eligible to receive the PPP, which is the Paycheck Protection Program loan. Now, I know a lot of you have heard about the PPP. So this is a forgivable loan that you can use for certain expenses that are named in the agreement, such as payroll or rent. So for it to be forgiven, you do have to follow the designated expenses that they have outlined in the agreement. So make sure you check for that. I would, as an entrepreneur, I would personally suggest that you have a separate bank account for these funds so that you can properly track them, okay? Not just for good records, which you should be keeping as a business owner anyway, but for the fact that you want to have proof of your use of funds, so that way when it is time to maybe submit documents later down the road to show what we used these this money for, you have it properly kept up, your books are well kept. So I would just suggest doing that to make tracking easier. So if you have not taken advantage of the PPP, I would definitely recommend that you go ahead and submit your application. I received the funds and it has helped dramatically with my business. So last thing when it comes to the PPP is if you are collecting unemployment, you cannot get the PPP and continue to collect unemployment. You must stop your unemployment when you do get the PPP loan. So just keep that in mind that you can't receive them both at the same time. So the second update is the EIDL new application opening. All right, so they recently reopened the EIDL application, which is the economic injury disaster loan, and that is an advance of up to $10,000. So I believe it is $1,000 per employee that you can get an advance of up to $10,000. So according to the SBA website, this loan advance does not have to be repaid. So it's basically free money, you guys. That's what it's saying. And recipients do not have to be approved for the loan to receive the advance. That would be the SBA loan. So you don't have to be approved for the SBA loan in order to receive the advance. But the amount of the loan advance will be deducted from the total loan eligibility. So for example, if you are eligible for a $10,000 SBA loan and you get the $1,000 advance, you are now only eligible to receive $9,000 more from the SBA loan. And so make sure you guys go apply to that. Now, I did apply for the EIDL. I didn't receive the SBA loan. I got PPP, but I was denied the EIDL loan. So take your chances, apply. I know several people who were who did receive the loan, and you can receive this loan very quickly, like same day. I know someone who received it in the same day, or you can receive it really just a couple of days after you apply. So another great resource for you to take advantage of. Now, Let's get into some talk about the second stimulus check and then unemployment. So there's a lot of talk about the second stimulus check coming. And yesterday on July 1st, in an interview with Fox News, Trump stated that the next stimulus check would be very generous. Okay. So we gonna see. He stated that he supports larger numbers and that it has to be done properly. He quoted that specifically, that it has to be done properly. And he said he wants the money getting to people to be larger so they can spend it quickly and in a non-complicated fashion. So obviously he wants to get the economy back running. Now, many of you know that if you qualify and receive unemployment through your state, you get an additional $600, all right? So that's a good little chunk of change, you heard me? Okay, and that's supposed to end on July 31st. But Trump was asked also about an extension and whether or not that $600, that figure would change, whether it will go up or go down. And when he was asked about it, he basically said that they're going to be meeting soon to make a decision. And he quoted, it's going to be good numbers, a substantial number, and that people are going to be very happy. So we'll see what happens with unemployment. As of now, like I said, you can collect up to $600 extra of unemployment through July 31st. So we'll see what happens to that after July 31st. A big reason why they are considering, or why he was asked about changing that number, is because a lot of people do not want to go back to work because they are making more money being unemployed and collecting unemployment than they were at work. So a lot of people have no incentive to go back to work. So we are just waiting to hear back on what is going to happen when it comes to unemployment and how that number may change. All right, you guys, so those are the main updates that I have as it pertains to resources for entrepreneurs, kind of what's going on, and I will be keeping up to speed on these things. So please let me know if this was helpful for you. It's going to be some quick, dry, you know, raw updates, so there won't be much editing, but I do think it's important to get this information out very quickly because a lot of things change, and the quicker you can be on top of receiving or applying for these resources, the more likely you are to get them. So keep looking out for these updates. I will create a separate playlist on my channel so that these are easy to find, and you know, always watch the more recent one as soon as you can so that way you're not missing any information. All right, you guys, I love you and I will see you on the next one. Peace.